entropy as a means for understanding the world. The chaos of life that you receive through your sensors that you utilize to make sense of the world. Picture yourself in a sensory deprivation tank. No noise, no sights. All you feel is water on your skin, which in reality is just pressure receptors and temperature receptors in your skin that your brain has come to understand as the feeling of water. This is your baseline. As baseline is established, your body comes to expect a certain level of activity. This would mean that your body, by remaining in the sensory deprivation tank with no change in stimuli, will experience zero entropy externally. Technically, it's near zero, not literally zero, because there is still water that's changing where it is around your body. There is still some surprise, so don't let me use a binary here. Why? Because you are not receiving other sensory stimuli that are changing, the entropy of what comes, more visual blackness, audio blackness, water on your body, is expected. Because this is what your brain anticipates, there is no chaos in this scenario. Your brain is allowed to roam free and create internal entropy because it does not exist from the outside. Your brain may begin to delve into topics that cause a lot of emotional disturbance for you. Those would be your high entropy feelings that you have yet to understand. It may create hallucinations for you, such as audio or visual or sensory, like pressural hallucinations. This is creating entropy internally because it does not have to deal with extreme amounts of entropy externally. Okay. Now, in the sensory deprivation tank, you hear the door unlatch. You were not able to expect this, so you're caught by surprise. The entropy of this sound was unexpected. Door opens and light floods into the sensory deprivation tank. Your eyes hurt as they adjust to this newfound stimulation from the world. The entropy has raised as now you need to process more senses. There's more input, more stimulus that your brain has to make sense of. Okay. Take, for example, me walking in circles outside. I feel the grass beneath my feet. I feel the wind on my body. I see my dog. I see nature around me. I can come to expect by walking that my walking will move me in the environment to where I am going to. The entropy of me walking somewhere that I have walked many times before is very low. There's not much about this that my brain is taking notice of that is different. Leaves may be different, grass may be slightly different, but overall, my brain holds the semantic label of our backyard. And with that, there is flexibility inside for that label to change. My brain can still identify this as my yard, even if there are more or less leaves on the ground, if the grass is cut or less cut. The entropy is low. However, if I were to come outside and the yard was on fire, or there was a vehicle in the yard, this would catch me off guard. I do not expect a car or vehicle in my backyard, and I may begin to feel emotions inside of me. The entropy from external stimuli has now made its way inside of me through my visual receptors. Maybe I heard audio receptors of the fire burning. I feel the heat and the pressure of the smoke and flames outside. my body begins to generate emotions and feelings regarding this entropy. What is this? Why is this happening? What can we do? How do we fix this? In my body's attempt to understand this, I take the entropy from outside and I process it into myself. I do this subconsciously. We've done this since we were children. You come into the world, extremely high entropy, and you begin to process it. However, now I have much more lived experience to handle how we reduce the entropy in the future. If my yard is burning and I am panicking of the yard, I have a few options to solve the thing that is causing me too much entropy. I can continue to stare at the fire, continuing to feel the heat, processing it more, coming to understand it better by processing more data about it. Maybe I identify a source of the flames, or I identify why they're if there's a person inside of the burning car on my yard. Things like this. So I can sit there and gather more information to reduce the entropy. I can leave the situation. If I am somebody who is prone to not remember things, dissociation, overstimulation, abandonment, I will leave the environment. Maybe I go inside and I pretend like the fire doesn't exist. It will happen. Whatever happens will happen. It is what it is. In this scenario, I would probably burn down with the house, but that is another option. Another option is I could go through the house to the other side, get in my car, and leave. Take an action to separate myself from the flames. A final option would be to attempt to deal with the flames directly. Maybe I attempt to take a fire extinguisher and extinguish the flames. Or I see the burning person in the car, I run and I try and save the person from the car. Potentially, my brain and body has been trained for these situations so that these are not too entropic. I don't panic, I don't lose control, and I'm still able to handle myself. This is why many trainings are just repetitive action. Rather than just learning, you need to embody the situation so your body and your brain together as a collaboration understand what to do in the moment. Just because your brain understands something does not mean that your body has done the same level of processing and understanding and engram building as your brain. Vice versa, if your body has been trained to act a certain way, regardless of how your brain feels, there can be a disconnect between how your body acts and how your brain actually wants to act. So it can be important to understand the disconnect to reconcile the difference. So in scenarios that cause extremely high entropy, which isn't necessarily a burning me backyard, it can also be a conversation with somebody. Maybe a conversation you have is anxiety inducing. That anxiety is the feeling of entropy inside of you. That is the feelings of uncertainty and concern and fear. And with that, the world and understanding of it changes. All sensory inputs that you feel, all emotions, they're simply entropy. They're chaos from the outside that has been morphed and reformed inside of you. As with the bird from this last video I made, as with the bird example, you are the alert siren that is taking the chaos of the world, repackaging it, and giving it to other people, however you choose to do that. To go back to the bird example, the bird takes in the visual data of the danger, they take in the audio data from that danger. Maybe they stepped on a leaf or a stick, and they transmit that data, and maybe they see a fox, they say, fox, and then the other birds hear that, they repeat it, and now there's a danger fox here. So understanding that all sensations, all feelings, all of everything is merely chaos, which generates entropy for you as an intelligence, as an autonomy. And with that, you're able to utilize that understanding to potentially be less reactive in certain situations. Maybe you're able to meta-analyze your environment in a way that makes you less anxious now, because you realize that the meta around the information. You're not just panicking in the moment. You understand this is a lot of overstimulation. My brain needs to process this information more, or it needs to collect more information, or it needs to escape from the situation. Regardless, understanding how the chaos of the world and the entropy it generates is impacting you is vital for your own understanding. But I think that's all I got. I love you. Goodbye.